hello.
Oh, hi, Ken. How was your evening?
Oh, it was terrific, thanks. Alma certainly knows how to throw a good dinner party.
Oh, yes, I know. And, well, I know she went out of her way to make sure it was special.
Yeah, I couldn't help noticing, though. She didn't look very well at all.
Oh?
I mean, she's gone to a great deal of effort, so perhaps she was just tired.
Yes, I expect that's it. Would you excuse me? I've just got a dash. Are you sure you're okay?
Mum, will you stop fussing? I'm fine.
Hello.
Right, I'm gonna have to go. I'm gonna be late for school.
Oh dear, someone's not a happy bunny. Oh,
she's just fed up.
I'm sure. I know she tries, but she's just too young for all this care and worry and responsibility. She should get out and have fun more while she still can.
How's Alma?
Well, at least she's not in pain. Do you know, I may not be able to do much for Alma, but I can do something for my granddaughter. You, my love, are going to take her away on holiday.
I am?
Yes, you are. My treat.
What happened?
I've got the night off tonight, if you fancy going to the movies.
I can't. I'm going out with the girls tonight.
All right. You got a plan?
Just going down to some new club in town.
Bored of married life already, dear?
No, I'm just keeping you on your toes, mate. Don't want you taking little old me for granted now, do I?
So, tell me, if some big hunky bloke comes up and offers to buy you a drink, you're going to take him up on it, eh?
Yeah, too right. Saving my pennies for my honeymoon. Speaking of which, should you not be thinking of taking a walk down to the travel agents today?
Well, it depends.
On what?
Well, I'm not going to spend my hard-earned cash on a trip to the States if my beloved wife is going to run off with the first guy that buys her a drink.
Listen, you. There's only one fella that I'm going anywhere with. And I'm looking right at him.
How are you feeling?
Like my head's been on the end of Beckham's boot.
Yeah, well, so. He did manage to put away a fair amount of booze.
Mm. No kidding. Well, thanks for staying last night. You didn't have to, though.
Yeah. Just wanted to make sure you was okay.
Sorry. Made a right fool of myself, didn't I?
Yeah, don't be daft. Did have me worried for a minute, all those pills lined up.
That was stupid.
Hey, don't be hard on yourself. Maybe you should go and see someone. Talk it through.
Yeah, maybe. You should get to work.
Not leaving you on your own.
No, I'll be fine, really. Gotta go to work myself.
Sure you're up to it.
Well, I'm up to my eyeballs in debt, remember? Skiving off work ain't gonna help.
Right, I'll go then.
Kevin, about the pills. You won't tell anyone, will you?
It's between you and me.
Thanks.
Just don't go trying it again, OK?
Oh, hiya, love. How's it going?
Oh, yeah, great, thanks.
Oh, you and Curly must be dead excited with a kiddie, aren't we?
I'm still getting used to it, to be honest.
Well, once baby's here, it'll seem real enough, believe me.
Yeah, it's a good job Norman's organised. If it was left to me, it'd be business as usual, and I'd end up giving birth in a ditch in my lunch hour.
Oh, you'll soon get hang of it.
Actually, Vera, I wanted to ask you something, and be honest with me. Is it really as painful as they say, you know, childbirth?
Well, put it this way. If I had my time to come over again, I'd want hitting on the head with a brick. But it's worth it, love.
Hiya.
Hiya. Found anyone to help out with the shop yet?
No, no, not yet. Look, I just wanted to say, I'm really sorry that I laughed at you. Didn't mean it.
No, I'm sorry. That's like a rat plank coming onto you like that.
True. But then your brother explained and how the eggs you won. I suppose I should be flattered, really.
Look, can we just not forget the whole thing?
Yeah, I already am.
Really miss working in the shop, you know.
Well, I miss having you. But you wouldn't want to come back, would you?
Must be kidding. I'd jump at the chance if you... Well, if you offered, that is.
Well, when can you start?
Stop down and wind it off. Look who's here. It's Mr. Bean.
Aw, could you not keep away from us?
I can.
Aw, I'm surprised you remembered my name.
How could I forget?
Harvey, to what do we owe this honour?
Them undies weren't so themselves.
My father's finally stepped down. As of next week, I'm officially head of the Reuben Empire.
Oh, congratulations. I suppose this means we'll be seeing more of your old men on the golf course, eh?
Let me hope. We're looking to increase some of our subcontract work, if you're interested.
Oh, music to my ears.
Well, we should fix up a time to talk.
Well, I'm just on the way out at the moment, but Linda will look through my diary, make an appointment, eh?
Yeah, fine.
Some of you better.
Mike, you better get going, or you'll be late for your meeting.
Eh? Oh, yeah. Nice to see you again, Harvey.
And you, Mike.
Well, I suppose we should be flattered. You're so keen to get your hands on our knickers.
Strictly business this time.
I said I'd lend all them books to Emily.
You all right, Gail?
Oh, am I glad today's over? It was chaos in the surgery today. I mean, first of all, the computer went down, and then Molly phoned in sick again.
What, she didn't turn in at all?
No. How was she last night when you went to see her?
I didn't go in the end.
Well, she probably wasn't up to having visitors. I mean, she sounded terrible when I spoke to her.
Yeah, look, I've got to shoot, Gail. See you later.
I'll see you.
I told Emmy she should consider birth pool. I mean, the baby's been in water for 9 months. May as well swim into the world. And she's going to have to start taking it easy from now on, so it kind of got me thinking a bit.
Well, what?
Well, we're not tied down with a baby yet, so maybe we should get out a bit more and enjoy our freedom.
What, all the time, Max?
Yeah, to the Rovers. I was on about doing something different for a change.
And like what?
Don't know. A theatre? A club?
I'm not really in mood, be honest.
Ash, a night out cheer you up.
Don't need cheering up. Anyway, I said to Boris to go for a quick drink with him after work.
Oh. Right.
I better be getting back.
Right, this is the viewfinder that you look down. This is the manual focus. And this is the automatic focus should you need it.
Yeah, well, that all seems a bit technical to me, does that?
Oh, it's easy. A kid can use it.
Hey, you are talking to a woman who needs an instruction book to use a microwave.
Look, all you've got to do is set it up. Set the shot that you want, point it and shoot.
Yeah, well, I'm sure I'll get the hang of it eventually.
Well, what do you want it for anyway?
Oh, it's just a sort of, a video diary thing. It's nothing special, just something to show friends.
Yeah, well, they are good for keeping precious memories.
Yeah, well, that's what I thought. Hey, you're going to be filming the birth.
Oh, I don't think Emma would like that, do you?
You know, I'm thrilled to bits for both of you. You deserve all the happiness you can get.
You know, I never thought I'd get another chance in a million years. Not after Raquel. But it shows you, you never know what's around the corner, do you?
No. It'd be nice to think that I'd be around when the little one arrives.
I don't know how you handle all this. If I were in your shoes, I'd be going off my head.
Well, there are days when I am, believe me.
Well, you don't show it.
Well, I suppose most of the time it's because it still seems unreal. It's like I'm caught up in some weird suspended animation with me stood still while the rest of the world continues around me as usual.
Well, remember, you're not on your own.
Right, come on, let's run through this again. Then we're going to the Rovers for a well-earned drink.
Okay.
Okay.
Right, viewfinder.
Viewfinder.
Right. This, manual focus.
Manual focus.
Right.
So how was school?
It was all right.
Well, I've got some exciting news.
Really?
Ooh. How do you fancy a weekend away?
Where?
London. Your nan's treating us.
Really? That'd be brilliant.
Mm, I thought that'd please you.
What about Bethany?
She's coming too. It's all girls together.
We're going down on the train and staying in a posh hotel.
Oh, we have not been away for ages. And we have got to go to all the shops. We have got to see Buckingham Palace.
Well, don't wear me out before we get there.
Listen, I'm going to have to go and tell Candice because she's going to be so jealous. Right, I'll see you later on.
I'll see you later. Ooh, what's all this?
Accounts.
Go on then. How much is the McDonald Empire worth?
I shall let you know as soon as I've included your assets.
Right, well, that's £3.50 then. Got paid this afternoon.
You'll spend most of that by the end of the day. Anyway, I'm gonna stop. I need to find a dress for tonight. See you later.
See you later.
Right.
Been to travel agents?
No. Well, I haven't had a minute.
Steve, you promised me.
Well, I'll go, I promise.
Right, well, don't leave it too long. I might just take some other fella away with me on honeymoon. Joke?
Molly! Molly, it's Kevin, open up! Molly! 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 Molly!
Kevin! What the hell do you think you're doing?
Flaming state of my door. What's left of it?
Yeah, well, Gail said you're phoning sick. And when you didn't answer, I thought...
Well, I decided I couldn't face work, so I took another sicker. I was at the shop.
I don't believe this.
No need for these, then.
Poor Ashley, it must have come as a terrible shock.
Yeah, he's taking it really badly.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. Blokes are dead sensitive about their fertility. Plus with all that macho stuff.
Mm. It's really knocked his confidence, especially in the bedroom. He doesn't seem to want to come near me.
No offence, Maxine, but it's not your needs you should be worried about right now.
I know, I've taken a back seat, but he just seems to find excuses to avoid me.
Well, you can't rush him. I mean, his ego must be as flat as a pancake. You just have to take things slowly.
I know, I just wish I could do something to cheer him up.
I suppose all you can do is reassure him, you know, let him know how much you love him, make a fuss of him, but don't go over the top.
No, you're right, actually. I'll cook him a really romantic meal, he'll like that. Cheers.
See ya.
Hiya. I was just passing. Actually, I need a fuse for the Hoover.
Come to have a nose more like.
Well, that's an interfering mother's prerogative. I'm dead chuffed you got your job back.
Yeah, me and all. Beats working at a lousy catering agency.
So, does that mean you're coming home?
No.
But I thought that you...
I'm not living under the same roof as him.
Oh, come on. Dennis hasn't done out.
Typical. Always taking the bloke's side. You don't give a stuff about me or Todd, do you?
Oh. He's my boyfriend, and it's about time you grew up and realised that I'm entitled to a life of my own.
Oh, do what you like. You always do.
Oh, that's right. Throw it all back in my face, as per.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but there's no way I'm coming home until he's gone. And it's not just Dennis. It's any bloke. The house just ain't big enough.
You're just being stubborn now.
If I come back, we'll only clash. And you know it's true.
I want you home, Jason, but Dennis is staying.
It's okay, then. I'll stay where I am.
There you are, love.
Thank you, Betty.
Okay.
I'm not being intrusive, but is something going on?
What do you mean?
Well, with Elma, have you two fallen out?
What on earth makes you think that?
Well, you weren't at her meal last night. And every time I mention a name, you can't get off the subject quickly enough.
No, we're the best of friends, really.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
Hi. Right, oops, I'll leave you to it.
Thanks. So what are you doing here?
I don't know, the same as you.
Bottle, please, and a gin and tonic.
Norman, okay, over here a minute.
Hi.
Oh, it's all right, go ahead, yes.
Right. Alma, this is the last place you should be. Why? The smoke, the noise, do I need to go on? No, will you just stop treating me like a child? Yeah, all right. Come on, let's find you somewhere to sit down. Look, I wish you'd stop treating me like a doddering geriatric. Alma, You're supposed to be taking it easy, right?
Yes, all right. Well, if you see me climb onto the bar and start doing the can-can, please feel free to hassle me then. But until then, would you mind just letting me get on with trying to enjoy my life?
Everything all right, love?
Yes. Yes, thank you.
That Harvey don't half fancy himself.
Oh, he's young, he thinks he's invincible. A couple of months running that business, he'll get his wake-up call.
He needs taking down a peg or two.
Oh, he's all right. He's just got a lot of learning to do.
So long as he keeps his hands off our staff this time, he's all right, Sleaze, from what Karen tells me.
Yeah, you know, for all his business sense, he's got a terrible taste in women. You know, I hate to say this, but Alma and Arf looking rough at the moment.
Do you mean you've only just noticed?
Yeah, but she's letting herself go to seed. That's not like her.
Good job you traded her in for a younger model then, isn't it?
No.
I told her.
Here you go, Van Damme.
Thanks. Look, I'll pay to have it fixed properly, but that should be OK for now.
Oh, don't worry. The councillor's supposed to be replacing him anyway.
I was really scared for a minute back there.
Sorry. I made a right mess of things, haven't I?
What I don't understand is you always seem so...
happy? Easy going?
Yeah. You're the last person I'd expect to be, you know.
Well, you can only keep up a front for so long. Wears you down eventually.
Yeah, but what's a bad way you want to kill yourself?
Look, I thought we went over this last night.
Yeah, but I still don't get it.
Look, I've had enough, all right? I'm up to me eyeballs in debt. My last fella did a bunk, the house was repossessed, I had to sell the car and all the furniture. All I've got are the clothes on my back and the banger. Do you get it yet?
When I lost Jake, and then I lost Alison, I was going off my head. I thought I was going to do something stupid, so I do understand what you're going through.
Yeah, I'm sorry. It puts my stupid problems in perspective.
I'm not saying that just to make you feel bad. I'm saying it to let you know you're not on your own. There are people out there who know what it's like to hit rock bottom.
You're dead brave, you.
No, I'm not. I've just got to keep going for my two kids. I owe it to them to make the most out of life.
Thanks, Kevin.
What for?
Forget the tea. Let's go for something a bit stronger. Emergency supply.
I'm up for some of that.
Steve, I've been thinking about our money situation.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I just think it'd make more sense if we had a joint bank account.
What? You've already taken over the flat.
No, it's our flat now, thank you.
And now you want my money as well, do you?
Married, aren't we?
Yeah, we'll be bankrupt this time next week.
Hey, I'm not totally soft, you know. I can be dead sensible with money when I wanna.
Yeah, especially when it's somebody else's.
Not trust me.
No, it's not that. It's just that I think we'll be better off with our own money, then we can do what we want. And I don't want to start arguing over who's spent what.
Well, I just thought it'd be nice, you know, to share things, like a proper husband and wife team. Mike and Linda have got a joint bank account.
Yeah, exactly. I don't want you ending up like that money-grabbing cow.
Oh, well, thanks. I thought you might have just thought about it, that's all.
All right, well, then, yeah. Listen, fancy having dinner guests over this evening?
What, here?
Yeah. You're the one that wants to start acting like a married couple, so I think we should start entertaining like Mr. and Mrs. MacDonald and invite Vic and Bobby over.
We haven't exactly got much choice inviting Vic over, have we? When's he moving anyway?
Don't change the subject. Are we having this meal or what?
All right.
All right, cool. You could do the cooking.
No, I ain't got a minute.
I'm working till 7:30, and do you want me to start thinking about this bank
right,
again?
Right.
All right. So, Liz,
supposed to be a surprise to cheer you up.
Another tip from one of his stupid magazines?
No, actually. Emma thought it'd be a good idea.
You've been discussing our personal problems with Flaming Emma?
I was only telling her how low you were feeling.
Oh, did you have a good laugh, did you, about my little problem? Well, thanks very much. Be all over Weatherfield by tomorrow morning.
I don't even know why I'm bothering to make an effort. You obviously prefer going out and getting bladdered with Boris.
Yeah, well, who can blame me? All I've had for the last 12 months is babies, babies, babies. I've had enough. What's the point?
We can get through this. I know we can. All
just
we have to do...
leave it, will you, Max?
Here. I know it's no big deal, but you don't have to pay me for the car.
No.
No, I mean, I've knocked your front door, so it makes us even.
OK. Thanks. I don't know what the neighbours must have known. Your face when you saw me coming back. Oh, Shannon, come
on. I felt like right plonking.
Yeah, that makes two of us. Kevin, I think you're a really special bloke, and I'm not just saying it because I'm off my face, but you've been really good to me.
Yeah, give over. It's not.
Maybe it is the booze, but I do feel much happier about things. Just having someone here makes me feel more safe. I feel like I can cope. I know I'll get through this. I just got to be stronger.